Hello students. So in this video we are going to convert the orthographic view into isometric. So front view and top view of an object we can see in this figure. So radius 35 mm it is given for this half circle, total 40 mm and 15 mm for the back end rib. So initially we require to calculate the length, height and width of the object. So length of the object in front view we can calculate the length of the object, that is a total diameter of the half circle means 35, total length of the object it is 75 mm, total length 75 mm, height of the object that is 20 plus 40 and outer radius 35 means total 95 mm height, and width of the object in top view we can see 15 plus 40 plus 35 means total 90 mm width of the object. So initially the O position is given in the top view, so we start from the top view. When we pick up this object as it is and when we place here, the O position will comes at this end. So in this problem the O position it is given here. So by using this O position, when we pick up this view as it is and when we place here, the O position will comes at this point and the total length of the object on this side. So this is the total length of the object. So mention the length of the object here and the width of the object, total width of the object will comes on this side. So this is the width of the object. Then from this point, so initially we require to prepare the block. Total 35 mm is the radius, total block diameter it is 70 mm. From this point, so prepare, mark the point at exactly 70 mm and vertical height. The thickness of the horizontal plate it is a 20 mm, then mark the 20 mm above. On both these sides 20 mm with the same, and the width of the object it is given 90 mm, total 90 mm is the width of the object. Then next just prepare the block exactly length and width. So total length of the object already we have taken, that is a 70 mm from this corner to this corner, and total width of the object it is a 90 mm. Then find out the center point. Is present at exactly at 35 mm. Connect these two points with the center and find center line. In top view we can see this point, center point 30 mm away from the O. Mark 35 mm and then draw the center line. You get exact point, center point. By using this we can create the half circle here. We'll start with the creating the exact 70 by 70 block. shorter diagonal. By using this shorter diagonal, here is the half circle, it is present. The shorter diagonal connect, this is a point A, we can call it as a point A and point B. Point A to opposite midpoint. Point A to opposite midpoint, this we can call as A1 and A2, and similarly point B to opposite side midpoint. For shorter diagonal, point B to opposite midpoint, that is a B1. So we can use two centers. So first one is here and second one at corner, that is a crossing point, we can call it as a C1. Use the compass from A to A1, take a distance A to A1 as a center A, and we can complete the first arc. That is a A1 to A2 and radius A to A1. Similar way, the C1 is the center. Take distance, that is a B1 or A1, and complete the arc. The same arc, it is present throughout the object. So at the base also same arc it is present. So shift these center points 20 mm below towards the height. Towards the downward direction. Take exact 20 mm. Direction 20 mm, and with same radius A to A1, keep on point, and again we can draw the arc. Same with the C1 to B1 or A1 radius, shifted point is here, from this to this is a 20 mm, and draw the arc. Then draw the tangential line, repeat this arc if it is not. So top view we can see this part. Now for the vertical plate, total height it is given 40 mm and center line it is present. So take vertical line, projection line, and mark at exactly at 40 mm from both the corners. Then draw the horizontal center line. Exactly at middle, means at 35 mm, vertical center line. With the same half circle, it is a present in this top face. So again, use the same method, construct the block 35 by 35. From this point, the total 70 mm. 35 mm above and 35 mm below. The shorter diagonal it is present here. By using this, we can call it as the A point and B point. From A to opposite midpoint, we can connect for shorter diagonal. This point we can call as a A1 and it is sufficient. Only one we can connect from B to opposite midpoint. This point we can call as a B1 and the arc it is present here, that is 1/4 arc here and remaining will be here. From B to opposite midpoint, B2, the arc it is present between B1 to B2 and A1 to B1. We can use two center points. So first one is the point B and second one is the C1. With the B1 as a center point, B to B1 is the radius, B to B1 as a radius, and can draw the arc B1 to B2 arc, and B to B1 is the radius. With the same C1 to B1, we can take the radius C1 to B1 and draw the arc. This is the half circle, it is a present in front view. With the same arc, it is present throughout the width. So throughout the width, it is in top view, you can see the plate, it is present 15 mm. So total 19 mm, this is a total 60 and 70. And now remaining part, it is a 20 mm. We shift these two points, center points, means B and C1, exactly 15 mm towards the width, parallel to width. Parallel to width and shift this point exact 15 mm. Here, similar way, the C1 point also we can shift towards the width of the plate 15 mm. And by using the radius from B2 or B to B1 is the radius, the arc will start, the starting point. So initially we can finalize B2, B1 is the radius, shift the center point 15 mm and start the arc. Total 15 mm and the remaining C1 to B1. Draw the tangential line. Then visible portion, this edge is vertical edge visible, and this also visible. Thickness of the plate, and then corner, vertical edge, the corner is present here. This is the final answer. Stay connected for more videos.